So hey all, this is Chubhak here from Quantsapp. Welcome back to another episode. So in the previous videos, we had understood about something like bullish strategies, bearish strategies, and also the non-directional strategies of options. Talking about this video, what we are going to discuss is, we are going to discuss about the option Greeks. And as we do it at Quantsapp, we try to make the complex things very simple and very practical. So that is the agenda for this video, to make the each and every Greek very simple for us. So first, there are four type of Greeks: Delta, Theta, Vega and the Gamma. Okay. So let's try to understand it one by one and what exactly each and every Greek indicate basically. So the first one is the Delta. Okay. So let's try to understand Delta. Now what is Delta? In simple, I would say layman's term, Delta is basically how much your premium is going to get affected due to the movement in underlying. So let's take an example over here, Nifty 29 July 21 futures. Delta is 0.54. Okay. Now, which tells us that if Nifty goes up by 1 point from here, this 15,800 call quoting at a premium of 78.45 will be increased by 0.54 paisa. Okay. So to sum it up, if Nifty goes up by 1 point from here, our call premium of 15,800 will go up by 0.54 paisa. If Nifty goes down by 1 point from here, our premium will go down by 0.54 paisa. So now let's try to simulate the effect of it very, very quickly. Now let's say Nifty is quoting at a price of 15,818. If I am giving application an input like what will be my call premium if Nifty reaches the level of 15,819, I'll click on update. See, the premium has gone up by 0.54 rupees over here. The premium which was quoting at 78.45 is now quoting at 78.99 because Nifty's price movement has gone up by 1 rupees from here, 1 point from here. Similarly, if Nifty goes down by 1 point, let's say it comes at the price of 15,817, our premium will go down by 0.54 rupees over here. So basically, Delta is nothing but how much your premium is going to go up and down due to the movement in underlying. And 1 point of change in Nifty is going to affect our premium as per the Delta out here. Also, Delta tells us, I would say, the probability of our option turning in the money, out the money or at the money. So now how it is. So now all the in the money strikes, their Delta would be very high as compared to an at the money and an out of the money, because those options first of all are having intrinsic value. The next one is basically all these options are having a much more higher probability, right, of expiring in the money because they are already having some intrinsic value. So now talking about 15,750 call and the above strikes, all their premiums are quoting above the premium of 0.50, correct, which means they are having a higher probability. Let's say if an in the money options, the premium, the Delta would be somewhere around 0.58, 0.60 and above, because they are having a higher probability of expiring in the money. Further, an at the money strike Delta. So what is the probability of at the money going in the money or out the money? Around 50-50, correct? So that is the reason an at the money strikes Delta would be somewhere around 0.48 onwards to 0.55. it would keep on differing as per the, I would say, pricing of options itself. Further, an out of the money option will have a very low probability of expiring in the money, correct? So the Delta of an out of the money strikes would be 0.40, 0.38 and all those things, because that options are not having any intrinsic value. Those options are out of the money. There is only time value of money left in that particular options. So the Delta wherein an out of the money options would be somewhere around 0.40, 0.38 and all those, because those options are having a very low probability of expiring in the money. While picking up an options trade, whenever we are buying an option, so I would say an in the money option will give you a much more faster return because the Delta is very high. So let's say if this one 15,900 call will move up only by 0.31 paisa if Nifty goes up by 1 point, but an 15,500 strike price call option will move up by 0.92 paisa due to 1 point move in the underlying. But also I would say the premium would be very high of an in the money option. So now coming to the second Greek. Second Greek is very simple and we have practiced it a lot of times. So practically what is second Greek? It is theta. So options, they are having a time value of money along with them, right? Like there is intrinsic value as well as the time value, which also involves the expiration date. Now options are not an investment we make. Basically they are an wasting asset. Each and every passing day our option will keep on decaying. That is basically theta. Theta is nothing but how much your option is going to decay if you hold that option for one more day. So talking about 15,800 call, if we hold this option for one more day, our option is going to get decayed by 11.45 rupees over here. So if we hold this option up till tomorrow day end, we are going to definitely lose 11.45 rupees despite Nifty move making anywhere. Like Nifty going anywhere, being at that level itself, still this decay is going to happen, that is for sure, due to the time value of money, due to the theta decay. So now the question is, when does theta decay happen? Theta decay will keep on happening even when the market is closed. Even at that time, the theta is definitely going to decay from the options itself. So in simple layman's term, what is theta? Theta is nothing but how much our option is going to get decayed if we hold it for one more day. So now talking about third Greek. So third Greek is Vega. Now what is Vega? Is it the volatility? It is the volatility factor, but is it the implied volatility of that strike? No. It is basically the impact of implied volatility on our premium. So now how is that so? So how much 1% in move of implied volatility is going to affect our option premium? That is shown to us by Vega. So I am in option calculator tool now to understand the Vega factor very, very easily. So now we have calculated the option prices. If the volatility of that particular option is 10%, strike price 15,800, evaluation date is today's date itself. Okay. So the premium which we got is 66.63 and put premium is 48.63. How much is Vega? 5.67 on both of the sides. Now I am giving application an input that what will happen to my premium if regardless everything remains the same and only if volatility goes up of this option by 1% from 10% volatility becomes at 11%, then what is going to be my effect on my premium? So my premium will get increased by the Vega factor, which was 5.67. So I will give an input to the application. Let's say calculate. Here I go. The premium is 72.30. So which is 66.63 plus Vega was 5.67. So 1% gone up the volatility. 5.67 rupees is the premium which has increased of that particular option, of call option of 15,800 call. So that is how the Vega works. So Vega is nothing but how much your option is going to get affected due to 1% change in the volatility. So as we saw, from 10 volatility went up till 11%, 1% of rise in the volatility, whatever the Vega value was, which was 5.67, our option got increased but that much amount of premium. Now talking about the last Greek, which is the Gamma. Now what is Gamma? Gamma, I would say it is a very small figure which becomes very, very active near the expiry date, wherein Gamma is the rate of movement of the delta. Okay. So in simple words, Gamma is an acceleration if the delta is speed. So if delta is the speed, Gamma is the acceleration. It tells us how fast our delta is going to move. So now if we are an option seller, especially if it is an expiry date, we should be aware about the Gamma risk. Now why is that so? Because ultimately if the Gamma moves fast, our delta will move fast. Our option will expire in the money very, very quickly. Our delta will move fast means what? Our premium will go up very, very fast. Alright. So in simple layman's term, what is Gamma? Gamma is nothing but how fast the delta is going to move. It is shown to us by Gamma, nothing else. Apart from that, I would say that was it from this video, wherein we practically understood what exactly each and every Greek stands for out here in option chain. So if you have liked this video, so do hit the like button, do hit the bell icon. So whenever we post something new, you will receive a notification.